you're going to find the naysayers in life that are going to tell you that what you think is wrong, or what you're trying is crazy, or how you're doing that is inappropriate. And so you have to challenge those notions. Just be aware of them, because after a while, pulls a little bit, and then you find yourself, why didn't I reach that goal? You can't do anything without commitment. You start there, and once you get through the barriers and you realize what's stopping you, then you can say to yourself, look, I'm totally committed. I want to do this. Now, what does commitment mean? If you think about the most successful people in the world, these are the people that have been beaten down over and over and over again, but stayed focused on their goal. You have to understand what you want, and then you have to believe what you want. And once you believe it, then you're on the road to commitment. There's resistance. There's what I call gravity, the gravity of life. And I talk about gravity because I think it's interesting. If you think about day-to-day living, right, there's always something pulling on you. Gravity's always pulling us. There's a couple things that keep gravity pulling on you. And the first one are people whom you associate with. And to understand that the people that you associate with can either bring you up or take you down. And so, if you have a friend who goes to the gym every day and works out, well, pretty much you're going to be going to the gym with this person and working out, and you'll probably be in better shape. If you have a friend who, drinks beer and hangs out, well, you're probably going to be drinking beer with this guy, right? Also, you're going to find the naysayers in life that are going to tell you that what you think is wrong, or what you're trying is crazy, or how you're doing that is inappropriate. And so you have to challenge those notions. Just be aware of them, because after a while, pulls a little bit, and then you find yourself, why didn't I reach that goal? Well, pretty much because you were conditioned by the people around you. The next thing is the environment. The environment is tremendously important to be aware of, to understand that things are going to happen. The best plans will always be interrupted, no matter what. You have the best plans in the world, and something's going to step in, and it's going to hurt you. So to be able to understand that this is just a something that's a barrier. It's not something that kills you. It's something that just stops you for the moment. And so I think that's really important to understand. So that's the first one. Commitment is really important. And if you could take that commitment and take that and keep it with you and know that things are going to beat you up and pull you down and jerk you around, then you're able to kind of get back on track.